Hey there, guys. This is Jesse with PermoFit. Wanted to bring you a plant update. So I'm in the middle of reorganizing my shop and cleaning it. And I got some plants here that I haven't let you guys know their progress in quite some time. So without further ado, let's go. So I have here some female and male kiwis. I have one growing out front, which I'll show you in a minute. It had a male and a female, and the female didn't make it because of my neglect. So in the meantime, I ordered another set, two sets actually, and I've been kind of scarce on the water, which I will try to make up. So this guy here are kiwi, the cold hardy kiwi. And they got an infestation, and I've been using this Azomax stuff, and it's been working fairly decent as long as I keep up on it. I had one plant go into shock because I used, I think, too much too soon. But in the meantime, I'm holding off a little bit. So this guy here is a bamboo. This is an ironwood bamboo. It's doing what I would consider fairly well, considering that we're nowhere near Asia or any of the Orient. These came from one seed, so I'm assuming the rhizomes or whatever it is clumped. This is clumping. You see a little. See if you can focus here. See one of the culprits crawling on there. So, anyways, that's what we're trying to kill. Now, the Azomax stuff supposedly only kills them after they eat the plant. So it doesn't do anything for the soil or anything else. So I'll work on that later. This guy here is my licorice basil. It's doing really well. I haven't used any of it, so it's just got tons of leaves on it. This here is Zep Collector 98 sent me the dragon fruit. And it's just growing and growing and growing. I have a main plant with a shoot putting out roots, and then another plant coming off that one, which is huge. And then I have this guy over here is growing around like that guy. This guy right here is growing up right there. The only one that hasn't done a ton is this guy right here, and it's got a root out the top, which is odd, but whatever. Lemon balm. I transplanted it, and it's got transplant shock. But as you can see, it's got some leaves it's starting to put out some new leaves. Mint, regular mint, chocolate mint. It goes through batches of where I don't get to water for a few days, and I have a little fan there blowing to circulate it because I'm trying to keep bugs down. And it does really good. It's putting out shoots everywhere. As you can see, my counter's a mess, but it's putting out stuff all over the place. And mint is just amazing. It recovers really well. So let's take you outside and show you some stuff out there real quick. You notice a couple of my previous videos. This guy's Buster. He's 13 weeks old, and he's a pretty good dog. Just about the smartest dog I've ever had. So let's unhook him here. Yes, Buster. Being good. Of course you are. You're a good dog. All right, let's go check out some plants, Buster. All right, so yeah, he just wants to go inside. Over. So this is my kale. These guys have had quite a bit of neglect. I have them right on the eve of this so I can catch some runoff, and they get watered by rain. But so this is my top hat blueberry. Half the plant, I don't know, I guess the blueberries do that where they die off and grow new. So the plant's okay, it's just lopsided. This is the male kiwi, which I've been neglecting a little bit with water, but it's doing pretty good. This guy here is a gooseberry, which are delicious when they're not ripe, they're tart, and when they're ripe, they're sweet, and it's putting up a new shoot. From what I understand, the gooseberry will actually, every time the root goes down and it comes in contact with the dirt, with the soil, it'll put out new roots and start off a new plant. And that's what I did over at a buddy's house who had them growing all over his property, is I just cut into the dirt, cut a little chunk of root with the two plants coming off, and put it in the ground. So this guy here is my pear, which is doing really good. No pears this season, but this is by far the biggest growth for the season. I've just been watering it every day to every other day. And this is my plum. These are both semi-dwarf. They're not gonna get any bigger than about 10 feet. And this guy here, they're both, and I think these are both 3 years old. So the 3 years that I've had them, so they're more than likely 4 to 5 years old. This guy's put off just a ton of new growth. It's slowly catching up. I don't think I'm gonna let him get too much taller than this guy here. Now the raised bed's been attacked by bugs and weeds. And as you can see, all this going here is weeds. I've pulled them out repeatedly. These guys here have thorns, something fierce. They got milky white substance in them, which is toxic, don't eat that. But I got two types of strawberries here. So I planted like more than 30 strawberries. This guy here has got June bearing and then ever bearing. And so I got the June bearing and I have the ever bearing. And then I got these weeds that are taking over everywhere. I've already pulled them several times. And he's the Azimax out here too. So then I got two pepper plants. And this guy, I just picked a big pepper. You probably actually see it out in the alley. No, it's gone. Anyways, I tossed it because bugs have already burrowed into it and eaten out some of it. But I'm still growing more here. So I'm hoping if I keep up, see this one here's got, see, 1, 2, kind of hard to see with the sun. Looks like I got 4 or 5 plant peppers coming off that one. And then my super sweet 100 cherry tomatoes, which are not nearly as sweet as last year's. Last year's were just phenomenally sweet. These guys, they're all right. But it might be the season too. And this is a new plum I got, semi-dwarf, this year. It's actually doing quite well. Kind of hard to see with all the other vegetation here. But that guy's only a week old. So anyways, that's my plant update. Oh, almost. I forgot to take you out front real quick here. Out front here, I put in a sprinkler system and just an above ground PVC. That's gonna be a tap so I can have the micro sprinkler lines going down. I had to put a cage around. My dog was digging up my blueberries. So I have here 3 different kinds of blueberries. Those guys, we went on vacation and they dried out really bad. And it hasn't put out any new leaves. Kind of hard to see. New leaves growing right there. So anyways, it is alive, it's doing new growth. This guy over here is doing pretty good. And a little guy over there is recovering slowly. And this tall guy in the background is, believe it or not, sugarcane. And once this thing got established, it's doing really good. Sorry about the traffic. I live on a main street. So, anyways, this is a red sugarcane, I think it's called. You can kind of see it's red. And it's already got 1, 2, 3, 4 pups coming up. I don't know if you actually call them pups, but that's all from one rootstock, which is just a piece of sugarcane that you cut and you lay it horizontal. And from the nodes, it grows more sugarcane. And I just put it in the sun and water it, and it's growing in a small pot. This is probably a gallon pot, and it's doing pretty good. It'll probably stunt its growth how tall it gets, which is fine. Because I honestly think they only get up to 10 feet, 8 feet, something like that. And I don't need it that tall. All right. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and check out some of my other videos. I got some project videos coming up. I've been saying that forever, but I actually do. I've got to finish cleaning my shop. And pitiful little Buster wants to say goodbye. Say goodbye, Buster. Say goodbye. Oh, good boy. Good boy. All right, bye, guys.